the United Kingdom, you have got locked down again. Welcome to the world in the US. And you really think Parliament is going to want to tackle any of this? And it could take an act of, and I will paraphrase it. She said that whether my life is long or short, I will be there to serve you. Abdication is a dirty word for the British monarchy. Ms. Queen also added Parliament would also need to be involved if the Queen ever decided to pass down the throne. She started with the British monarchy. She highlighted that why Queen was unlikely to abdicate and the few instances where she may be forced to. Ms. Queen said, go back to when Princess Elizabeth turned 21 years old. She gave a speech, recommended her Marlene Queen, has argued Queen Elizabeth II is unlikely to give up the crown and pass it on to her Prince Charles, despite speculation mounting due to her old age. And during an interview with express.co.uk, Ms. Queen insists that the abdication was a taboo. She said, secondly, abdication takes an act of Parliament. Edward VIII could not abdicate without an act of Parliament. Parliament has to pass the act and he signed it, and the Duke of York became king as King George VI. And it's not just like saying, hey, you can have a throne, because there is a whole process that you have to go through. And that might involve other things as well, but this certainly requires an act of Parliament. The royal expert hinted that the abdication was becoming even more unlikely due to the coronavirus pandemic. She continued, there are other things going on. Queen to refuse to hand over crown to Charles before death, as abdication is a dirty word. The Queen is very unlikely to hand over the crown to Prince Charles anytime soon, according to a royal expert. Parliament, Ms. Queen highlighted one of the few instances where the Queen may be forced to pass down the throne to Prince Charles early, and she said now the Queen becomes ill, the 1937 and 1953 Regency Acts come into play, and Princess Charles could be then the regent, just as the Prince of Wales was regent for George III and was known as the Prince Regent.